Most things we want to measure, for example, temperature or pressure, are continuously varying. The sensor data must be converted to a digital format before it can be interpreted by a microprocessor. Applying power to a sensor so that it produces a usable output is called excitation. Analog circuitry excites, filters, and amplifies the raw sensor signal, a process called signal conditioning. Once processed in this way, the signal is sent to an ADC, short for analog to digital converter. The output of the ADC is typically 8, 12, 16, or 24 bits. Data from an ADC is usually converted to a serial format such as I2C, SPI, or RS-232. Certain sensors, humidity in particular, incorporate the analog front end on a single chip solution, producing a digital output easily connected to a microprocessor. The raw output of most sensors is easily corrupted. Hence, signal conditioning circuitry is located very close to the sensor, helping to shield against external interference. Once converted, the digital signal can easily be transmitted over great distances with minimal error. It is helpful to use a microcontroller for sensor systems. This device consists of a microprocessor with a built-in analog-to-digital converter. In this course, you'll be using the Cypress PSoC series of microcontrollers. This microcontroller also contains amplifiers, multiplexers, comparators, timers, counters, and shift registers. It minimizes the number of discrete components between the sensor and the microcontroller. It is a hardware programmable part. You design electronic circuits implemented as real hardware inside the PSoC chip. The hardware then interacts with the code you write in a seamless manner. The design environment for this part is called PSoC Creator and includes schematic capture in addition to a code editor. In addition, a handful of inexpensive sensors and actuators will be made available for you to purchase for this course and future ones that are part of the specializations. Normally, you would need an expensive benchtop digital oscilloscope to take sensor readings, such as this one from Agilent. You may use this type of scope if you have access to one at work or school. However, for this course, you may also purchase an N-scope, a miniaturized version of the typical digital oscilloscope. Of course, it's not nearly as fast or accurate as the typical benchtop digital oscilloscope. Its power supply can only provide a modest amount of current, and the signal generator goes only to 10 kHz. The N-scope connects to your PC through a standard USB cable. It contains 4 input channels, so you can look at inputs, outputs, and other signals all at the same time. To learn more, go to www.nscope.org. That's N-scope spelled N-S-C-O-P-E. We hope you share our enthusiasm for building things. It's the best way to learn.